Afraid I don't know how. Cause there's a possibility that you look at me differently, love. Ever since the first moment I spoke your name, from then on I knew that by you being in my life, things were destined to change. Cause love, so many people use your name in vain. Love, those who have faith in you sometimes go astray.
My name is Terrence Sams. Thank you for joining me today. I'm originally from a small town called Lakeland, Florida. I have 6 brothers and 7 sisters. Large family, large family. My favorite time of the year are the holidays, and here's why. Because the holidays are special. My entire family would get together. My mother would prepare the meal, and my favorite thing that she would prepare is a red velvet cake. I love, even till this day, my favorite cake is a red velvet cake, but not just any red velvet cake. It must be my mother's red velvet cake. I mean, it's so moist and sweet. Ah, I can taste it now. Anyway, one time I asked my mother if she would be kind enough to share with me her red velvet cake recipe. She immediately said no. So I began to beg, like, Mom, please, please. I begged. I said, I'll wash your car, right? I begged her for years. And a few years later, she finally broke down and decided to give me her red velvet cake recipe. And so I was excited, as you can imagine. I went to the store, and I went down the list, and I purchased everything on the list. I took the ingredients home and ran to the kitchen and immediately began to just pour in the sugar and the butter and just mixing it up. And once I placed it in the oven, an hour later, the cake came out. And when I tasted the cake, it did not taste like my mother's red velvet. So I began to think, okay, something's wrong. Maybe I missed something. So I immediately made another cake. So I began to mix it up, put the butter and the flour and the sugar. An hour later, cake came out of the oven. I tasted the cake. It didn't taste like my mother's red velvet. And I began to think to myself, oh my goodness, what is going on? Like, did she miss something? So about 2 weeks later, I decide to try it yet again. I began to mix the ingredients with the sugar and the flour and the cream cheese. I mean, I mixed everything. Hour later, the cake came out. It did not taste like my mother's red velvet. So I began to become a little frustrated. So I called my mother. I said, Mom, something's wrong here. Like, you must have missed an ingredient. Like, I tried this cake 3 times. It doesn't taste like yours. So she said, well, son, read to me your ingredients. I read the ingredients to her. And she began to chuckle. She said, well, son, I gave you all of the ingredients, but there is one thing I forgot to tell you. She said, when you make the cake, when you mix it together, you must add in love. She said, son, you can have all of the perfect ingredients and mix it perfectly, but if you do not add love to it, it simply won't turn out right. Now, I begin to think, like, isn't that interesting that we can have everything that we need to be successful? We can have all of the perfect ingredients to make a major impact in our communities, in our neighborhoods, with our families, on our job. But if we're missing that one key ingredient, if we're missing love, we'll simply fall short. This is exactly what Paul is telling the church in Corinth. See, for 1 Corinthians 13, here's what Paul said. Paul said, if I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but didn't love others, I will only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains, but didn't love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I didn't love others, I would have gained nothing. Paul is simply telling you that you can have the gifts of prophecy, the gift of teaching or faith or speaking in tongues. And all of those are excellent gifts. But there is one gift that's just above those. There's one gift that's the greatest gift of all. That's more excellent than all of those, that all of the other gifts, and that is the gift of love. If we don't have love, we simply miss the boat. This is exactly what Jesus was telling the Pharisees in Matthew 22. Remember Matthew 22, the Pharisees came to Jesus and they asked him a question. They said, which commandment is the greatest commandment of them all? Out of all of the over 600 commandments or the 600 laws of the Mosaic laws, which one is the greatest? Which one can I rest my hat on? And here's what Jesus told them. Jesus said, the greatest commandment of them all is to love the Lord your God with all of your heart, all of your soul, and all of your mind. And the second one, although they only asked for one law, but he gave them two. He said, no, the second one is just as important as the first. He said, the second one is to love your neighbor just like you love yourself. Love your neighbor, because if you do this commandment, it will capture, encapsulate all of the commandments with this one commandment. We should desire to love like Christ. That should be our desire. See, Christ, he was led by the Spirit and he lived by the Spirit. So the fruits of the Spirit is joy, peace, kindness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control, and most importantly, love. The fruit of the Spirit is love. It is it's important that you understand that there is no sermon on love that will make us love like Christ loved. It's only the Spirit of God that came because of Jesus' love that can do that. Let me say that again. There's no sermon on love that will make us love the way Christ loved. Only the Spirit of God that came because of Christ's love, because of Jesus' love, that can do that. We cannot love the way Jesus loved until we live the way Jesus lived. And Jesus lived by the Spirit. He was led by the Spirit. So everywhere we go, when we go throughout our day, when we go on our jobs, and when we interact with our friends and our families or even strangers, we are to present and represent the love of Christ. When people see us, they should know that we love Christ by the way we treat each other. So here's my question to you. When people meet you, when they see you, when they watch you, when they observe you, can they clearly see that you love Jesus by the way you treat others? Can they clearly see that you love Jesus by the way you love others. So here's something I would like to give to you before I leave. I call it the now, the nuggets of wisdom. This is something that you can do right now that will help shift and change the atmosphere. So tomorrow or later today, at your earliest convenience, I would like for you to find someone, friend, family, preferably a stranger, and I want you to decide to show them a random act of kindness. It doesn't matter if it's giving money, or you can give your time, you can give your talents, but find someone and show them the love of Christ through you. Show them a random act of kindness. Show them what it looks like to be loved by God. So look, thank you for your time. That is 1 Corinthians 13. Like I said, my name is Terrence Sams. It's been a pleasure being here with you today.